one long.
Yeah, Lynn Munroe is in the position of being with two pairs inside the top 10. Jung Yi-ching and Jun Su-yu, the number 10 in the world, this pair.
Oh, in the same discipline.
Yeah.
Wow.
Because I think you were mentioning earlier how you felt that the more, I guess, more usual pair is Jung Yi-ching and him.
Right. They took the bronze medal in Tokyo 2020. Right. They've done wonders for the sport back home on the island.
Oh, that's lovely, isn't it, Lin Wenru?
He's definitely developed a lot of power. Look how taped up his hand in his wrist. I think Liang Jingquin, he was saying he was playing and he just started noticing pain in his wrist and had to stop the match, but he's taped all the way up to near the elbow here. Hasn't stopped him in the men's singles event so far. Or in this event either.
He has advanced well, but he was pushed very much so by Cohen Pang. In the opening round of this event, 4-3 he won.
Problems
to get across there for Jun.
Now, for those of you just joining us, newer to table tennis, in doubles you must alternate shots. So get in, get out quite quickly. Get out of the way, but not too far. And the serves must be cross-court from that side on the diagonal.
And because, Adam, we talk about it pretty much every time we talk about doubles, left-right is the preferred combination, which is what we have with both these pairs.
Right, it gives you a little bit of advantage to share the space more comfortably. The forehand is the more powerful shot for most players, and since you're alternating shots, you have a little bit more time to charge up. Don't need to recover quite as quickly as in normal rallies. I love that Coach Wei is fully decked out, tourist style here. Should have had a camera around the neck.
How about that from Lin Wenru?
Picking the short side of the table here with the backhand. He sees Wang Chuqin is going to love to turn that backhand corner. Watch Wang Chuqin's weight. And he doesn't want to cross over. That would be getting out of position. Very smart, aware play.
Five.
I should have pointed out at that point, it was a nice three-point lead for Jun and Lin.
Lin Wenru, I've had a chance to see over the years. I've known him since he was about 16, and he's really bulked up a lot in the legs. He's become a more massive figure. He's been playing around the world, contracted by nations galore.
Of build, I remember yesterday when Christian Carlsen was playing, we were talking about build. And he's very well built, but he's more an exception to the rule.
Yeah, it's interesting. The Croatians, there have been some massive Croatians as well. But yeah, it's important to be limber in table tennis. The legs and the core, that's super important.
I thought Jun earlier played a very nice shot. Not enough.
It's funny, I think just to compensate, we've been paying a lot of compliments to Lin Wenru and Jun Zuyu, but there's so much to say about Sun Yingsha and Wang Chuqin. Wang Chuqin, one of the most dangerous and aggressive players in the game. He's different than his teammates, and he's not far from being world number one.
Six.
But just when it looked like the Chinese were threatening to take the lead, it goes the other way. They have been in a good position so far in this. They've held their own. Jun and Lin.
Six.
Maybe the second towel break's a good time to remind you, but we're looking at the defending world champions in red. They've become massively popular as a mixed doubles pair because they've done so well, and they're two of the best players in the world. So it's a lot of pressure on both sides for the taped up two. Saw it on the neck of Jun Zuyu. Jung Yi-jing's still the leader of the women's team for the Chinese Taipei team. Jun Zuyu's been right there as a very strong supporting staff member.
But would you? It's pretty rare to see, I guess, a mixed doubles pair with one of them involved in both them ranked in the top 10, right?
It's funny you brought that up. Chuqin, I think, had three different partners that he had carried into the top 10. Can you imagine splitting yourself into thirds and still being top 10 in the world in all three? That's unbelievable. Yeah.
7 all.
Top edge there from Wang Shuqi.
Lin Minru using those legs to get low and really twist right at the waist to get that extra racket speed and spin on the ball.
Very tight one so far, this one. Was that there for the taking?
That shot right there is one of the shots that makes Lin Minru so dangerous. His over-the-table backhand is Chiquita, the banana flick. Just tucks in, gets that side and top spin. It's been beating Chinese opponents for years. Now 6 of the last 8 points to the world number one, the defending champs.
Yeah, it's a real shift, isn't it? And they're now up with a 2-point lead.
Again, if you're newer to table tennis, in doubles they'll signal to each other to make a non-verbal communication to be in preparation to understand how they can best set each other up.
Went for it there, didn't he, Wang Shuqi?
Well, he was left with no choice. I think going for it first, Lin Minru playing right on the line. The Chiquita, that's a tough place to play because the ball curves off the table and comes back on. Just drying the ball there to make sure. That is the responsibility of the server. If there's a wet ball and the receiver notices a wet mark on the racket, they'll show the umpire and they'll replay the point. But not the server. The server must dry it. Keeping the hand cool as well.
Yeah, you'll see a lot of that, won't you? Players blowing into their hands. Chiquita. Important there for Lin Minru to prevent the Chinese getting onto game point.
Yeah, this is as ripe as possible, right into the body, and the pattern's constantly changing. He went down the line last time, so Wang Chuqin's starting to lean a little bit to the forehand, and then right into the body, that elbow. A game that will be decided by the difference of 2 points, the smallest, narrowest margin for a victory in a game.
And it's the Chinese who get themselves onto game point here.
Interesting to see. It'll be nice to get a different angle of this. For Lin Minru, that's his shot. That's why the racket comes up. He's a quiet guy, hence the nickname, the Silent Assassin. But he makes that shot, I'd say, 9 times out of 10.
Ten all.
Deuce it is.
Good coverage there. Jun Ziyu had an awkward ball coming in. Wang Chuqin spins it, and right off the bounce, she just turns the racket to get the side of the ball, slow it down, and send it back. New ball, please. Thank you very much.
Tried to do what we've seen Lin Minru do there, Jun Ziyu, but it's game point here for Wang and Sun.
Very subtle serve. Wang Chuqin with almost no follow-through there. The contact as subtle as can be to keep it a guessing game on Jun Ziyu's side.
There's a lot of strapping going on for these two.
For this strapping pair.
Almost. Sun Yingxia and Wang Chuqin just seeing them through.
Love one.
Little punch earlier on from Sun Yingxia.
Not so common to see. It's not really part of her game so much.
2 love.
I tend to think of it as a little bit of a last resort. You know, Mima Ito's done incredibly well with it, and intentionally, she sets up her racket to play that game so well. Tomokazu's used it effectively, Hanagoda. But when you can add spin, it's a bit more security.
Yeah, interesting. The one I very often associate with punching is Adriana Diaz.
Oh, yeah.
And yesterday, I don't think we saw it once.
Well, she was playing a chopper, so it's, you're not going to
You're not going to get the pace coming at you,
You need the top spin coming in.
One, 3.
Yeah, I think there might be a determination, shall we say, from the Chinese not to risk getting pushed as close as they did. Quite often there's that kind of reaction, isn't there, in the follow-up game.
Yeah, definitely coming back well prepared here, starting off strong with 75% of the first 4 points.
Yeah, I think points are being made here on and off the table.
Now remember, not only have they switched sides of the table, but they've also switched the order of play here. And in the men's and women's games, there are a lot of differences, but here in mixed doubles, with this pattern of play, it can be quite jarring for both. They really have to adapt to unusual styles.
Four, just a second point two on the board for Jen and Lin. There we go. Doing a bit more of the Chinese support now. We've got a few banners around the venue as well. And this will grow, I'm sure, as the event gets closer and closer to Sunday.
Yeah, ticket holders are going to be quite thrilled for the later rounds of this event. We're already on day five. Oh, how time flies.
For free.
It's interesting, Zheng Ziyu, the pressure is, how do you make Wang Chuqin uncomfortable while handling the world number one's shots first? Quite a tall order.
That's how.
Four.
Exactly, my goodness, voice crack even. I love puberty. So here we go, the spin shot right into the body, a little bit off pace. Wang Chuqin might be looking for that forehand, right, but it never came. Good deception there from Zheng Ziyu.
Quite the discussion here going on between these two. It doesn't normally take this long.
Yeah, they will get warned from time to time. You'll hear the umpire say, please play.
Four, yep. Five.
After all that chat, didn't really work out for them.
A taste of his own medicine. Wang Chuqin had to deal with this in the last game, and now it's Lin Yunru. Gets a racket on it, almost curves it back around the net. Wow.
Six, yeah, Jen. Four.
Looking a little frustrated. There you go. There's that expression on her face.
Yeah, watch Sun Yingsha's final shot. That backhand, that's as much spin as you can put on a backhand. Quite the opposite of a punch in terms of aggressive shots.
Seven, four.
There again, something similar from Sun Yingsha. What we saw earlier. 3-point lead now for Wang and Sun. Yeah, this is starting to run away from them now in game two.
Heavy side spin on that one right there from Lin Yunru. Sun Yingsha leaving some on it, so the ball comes back and takes a little bit of a dip, bit of a kick on the bounce. I really think that's a wonderful look for Xiao Zhan.
I think it's a wonderful look for anyone who does it, frankly.
A little bit of chin hair and a shaved head.
Yeah, I've been known to do that myself.
I'll say hi when I see you tomorrow. You won't recognize me.
Five, eight.
What happened there?
Hit him in the hand. Not too often you see that. Not from Wang Chuqin. Take another look.
Time out.
And that.
Getting aggressive where they can. I think they're going to play with a little bit more spin, the Chinese pair. Let's see. They still have a 3-point lead.
You were nodding your head a lot during that rally.
Well, I felt lucky because my Mandarin's far from perfect, but it seemed like they were doing what I expected them to do. There was a long push from the start. They were trying to keep Lin Yunru and Zheng Ziyu behind the table, and they succeeded in doing that. But because of the spinnier shots, it was slightly slower. The Chinese Taipei team was able to counter back and be in position. They handled well. First point out of the timeout to the opponents.
This has been a really good period post-timeout for Chinese Taipei.
Yeah, it'd be tough for the Chinese pair not having a timeout left. I mean, they were up by three when they called the timeout. That's a nice, comfortable place to be score-wise. Xia Xia waiting in the backhand court looking to turn. But the cross court, Lin Yunru is so well aware where the opponents are, and you have to be at this level.
Three very good points for Chinese Taipei.
Eight, four.
That was probably the most audible advertisement for a can of any drink I've ever heard.
Perfectly timed, just as it goes into the net as well.
Service toss, conspiracy. No. Can you imagine? It's whoever's waiting for Team China in the next round. They're like, wait, wait for the soda, wait till the ball's in the air.
Right, go.
Okay, 8 points apiece now, tied up. We've had bigger distractions. I mean, load shedding hasn't affected the ball too much.
Banana flick eight, to the rescue. Nine. To stop that run of points from Jen and Lin.
It's been a long time, 8-4 up, as you called. It's not the first time, I guess. Second time in relatively recent history that he's gone down the line.
Wasting time.
So we've had a card here, Adam, and I'll get you to explain that a little bit more after this point. And it was something you actually flagged earlier as something that could well happen to the Chinese Taipei pair.
Oh, interesting. Yeah, I don't remember that, but either way, they were warned for wasting time. They've taken too much time. A lot of conversation. Oh, right, you said a lot of conversation. And I was going to say the umpire might warn them, please play, but it's not mandatory. A yellow card was a warn, simply a warning. But if it happens again, it's going to cost them a point. Two game points for the Chinese pair, the defending champs, to go up 2-0.
Nicely done. Bumped fist as well from Wang Chuqing. And it's again.
Forehand on everything. Trust your backhand. Play the forehand when it's there, but don't force it because you leave open the wide forehand side.
Love one. One all.
He's wanting to play that, isn't he? Lin Yunru.
Just amazing the subtle variations here on the serve. Sha Sha makes it look very simple, but makes it look quite heavy in terms of the spin. But the angle of the racket she comes in with leaves it a little bit empty.
Well, he got his in, didn't he? Wang Chuqin, the banana flick.
Good setup there. Not an easy one. Zheng Ziyu does her job. It's just Sun Yingsha, number one in the world, turns the corner, tough to deal with.
Liked how they were moving around the table there, Chinese Taipei pair.
For me, in this point, I'm watching Wang Chuqin, the way he moves, and we got the timeout now for Lin Yunru and Zheng Ziyu. He's getting there, he's here. Biggest event of the year.
4-1.
Yeah, again, we saw this previously where Chinese have surged, and to the credit of Lin and Jundi, they did bounce back. They don't want to let it get much beyond the 3-point mark.
2-4.
Which is the case here.
It was dangerously close to the back edge after coming off the top of the net there. A lot of hunger, you can feel it. Again, there's a lot on the line between these two pairs. The beauty of sport, right? It's just the great meritocracy, the equalizer. No matter where you're from in the world, you come out here, may the best pair win, the best players.
3-4.
Yeah, and they have reduced that deficit to just one. Remember that they have to win this game to stay in this match, Lin and Jun.
Five, three.
Now, is that a shot he'd feel frustrated he should have made?
Well, he took a chance here. Take a look. About to attack. No changes to push at the very last moment. I mean, that was as fast as can be. If it comes over, it's going to cause real trouble.
So that was his attempt at a deception.
Correct.
Six,
still maintaining that lead, the Chinese. Consolidating it now.
There's clear decisions being made right now. Wang Chuqin with the long push as Baby Buddha there hangs around the neck of Baby Buddha herself, Xia Xia.
4-6.
Yeah, you were talking about clear decisions?
Right. I think that Wang Chuqin and Sun Ying Xia have done a wonderful job of setting each other up. This is disrupted because Lin Minru has a very quality receive deep to the backhand. But in general, they push long, they spin long to set up the next ball. They're well in position, the Chinese pair, but only two in front.
Oh, she did well, didn't she, Jen, on the banana flick, receiving that?
Yeah, held her position perfectly, played it back down the line. A little help off the net there, a little fortune, but it makes it a one-point game.
Yeah, every time they're just about a point away, Jen and Lin, Wang and Sun just relieve that pressure.
6-4.
Wow, parity. It's been a while.
Doo-doom, 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 doo-doo-doom. Exciting times. Now or never for Zheng Ziyu and Lin Wenru. In terms of pressure, we've seen here as our tourist coach, Coach Wei, supporting the local experience. The hats, you gotta love them. South Africa's been so much fun to be here so far. Completely forgot what I was saying.
7-6.
And an outright service point here, Wang Chuqin. That stomp, it's a subtle shovel serve. Heavy side spin makes the ball carry off to the right. Zheng Ziyu just sort of shadow rehearsing what she can do there to strawberry it, keep it in play.
Again, that pressure has just been relieved by the Chinese.
Shovel serve once again. And a better response on the receive, less passive. Wang Chuqin moving forward, following through on that ball, just guiding it to the open table.
7-8. This is what they've been good at doing.
They
are dogged, Jun and Lin.
Probably the longest rally I can recall.
Yeah.
Heavy top spin, everything perfectly placed. That ball, you could see Xia Xia just trying to make sure she was out of the way enough, but not too far, still in the line of fire, courtesy of these two right here. She pulled the Zhang Jike, she dropped to the ground, and the ball goes over her head. Sometimes that's the easiest way to get out of the way. Watch one more time. Zheng Ziyu, where'd she go? Peekaboo. And the big forehand, here I am, still here, ready for action.
I like it.
Any newborns in the house watching right now? Where did he go? Boo-doo-boo-doo-boo. Best commentary ever. All right, tied up at 8 points apiece now in game number 3.
That's award-winning stuff right there.
Yeah, sarcasm's popular around the world. I love it.
And Chinese Taipei have gone in front here.
It's been a long time they've been working to get here. 1 point up the business end of the game. It's just a little bit. Far from time to relax. They're going to be laser focused here.
Yeah, I remember they were in this sort of position earlier on in the match. And it's 6 of the last 8 have gone their way. Well, we know what they can do.
That is a bullet. It is just one of those dodge this type situations. I mean, by the time the racket had even determined forehand, it was already off the edge of it. Power from the world number 2 in singles, world number 1 in mixed doubles, Wang Chuqin with Sun Ying Xia here. Two more points for the Chinese pair, and they've moved on through to the semifinals.
Oh, comes off the top of the post. Match point in hand for Wang and Sun.
Wang Chuqin does such an outstanding job of really getting up on his toes, reaching out in front for the slightly slower spinny ball. Could have caused trouble from Lin Wenru.
It's over. Wang and Sun progress on in there.